Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, we are going to be doing a final installation of the home automation server. So in this video, we are going to be taking the Raspberry Pi and mounting it on the network wall. First, let's go over the materials we are going to need for this. To start off, we are going to need M3.5 screws that are 20 millimeters, plastic M4 flat washers, about 20 of them, but I ordered 100, and black electrical tape. Then for tools, we need a drill, a Phillips screwdriver, some countersink drill bits, regular drill bits, and a label maker with label tape. The links to where to get all the materials and products I use will be in the description. While you are there, go ahead and press the like button, because if all 5 videos in the home automation server series hit 200 likes, then I will release the videos on how to actually use OpenHAB 2 sooner than it is scheduled. Let's get to work. The first thing we have to do is unplug the Raspberry Pi from the micro USB cable, as well as unplug the Ethernet cable. Then bring it over to a table and take the whole case apart, because we need to make some small modifications. Next, unscrew the Raspberry Pi from the bottom piece of the case and put it somewhere safe. Make sure you do not lose the small screws, so move them somewhere safe. Now let's modify the case a little. Grab a small piece of wood. I'm using a short piece of 2x4. This is to prevent the desk from being damaged. Then take the bottom piece of the acrylic case with the straight side to the left and the shorter side to the middle of the box facing you. Choose a drill bit that is bigger than the screws you are going to use to mount the Pi. The screws I have are M3.5, so I chose a 4mm drill bit. Next, grab your drill and put in the drill bit. I'm going to drill 2 holes for mounting. One is going to be in between the microSD card hole and the square cutout. The other hole is going to be in between the left edge and the square. Once the holes are drilled, you're going to countersink them so they are flush with the case. I chose a countersink bit that will make the screw flush. I chose a size 8 and found that it worked really well. Once you choose a size, put it in the drill bit and go to the hole and just start drilling. While you are drilling, take breaks to test and see how flush the screw is. When the screw is perfectly flush, then we are done, and then repeat the process for the other hole. Great, now both screws are countersunk. Put the case back together without the Pi inside. Bring it over to where you are going to mount and play around with its positioning. Keep in mind the locations of the ports and clearance. Once you choose its position, bring the case back over to the table and take it apart. After it is apart, find a drill bit that is smaller than the screw we are going to use to mount the case. Take the bottom piece of the case back over to where we are going to mount it and drill holes. Use the bottom piece as a template. When the holes are drilled, bring the bottom piece back to the table and put the 2 mounting screws through the holes. Then take 8 to 10 of the plastic washers and put them over the screws. The reason we do this is to provide a space between the bottom piece and the mounting surface so we can assemble the case on the wall. This is the tricky part. Grab the 4 screws that we used to mount the Pi to the case and stick them through. Now with all the screws in, bring it over to the mounting place and screw in the mounting screws into the pre-drilled holes. To prevent the Raspberry Pi from ever shorting, just in case, I put pieces of electrical tape over the metal mounting screws. Next, take the 4 plastic spacers using for attaching the Pi to the case and put them over the 4 screws we put in before screwing it into the wall. Then take the Pi in addition to the 4 nuts and mount the Pi to the case. Since we can't reach the screws, we will just finger tighten the nuts. All we have to do is assemble the case, so grab the microSD card side piece as well as the 2 long pieces and put them on. After, take the piece with the fan and connect the fan as well as put the piece on. Finally, take the piece with the port cutouts and put it on. Before we plug in the cables, I like to label them. I used my Dymo label maker and made a label for the 2 sides of the Ethernet cable as well as the power brick. I also labeled the actual Pi with what type of server it is and its IP address. Then I took the micro USB cable and the Ethernet cable and plugged them in. The automation server is now done in terms of hardware. In terms of software, it is set up. We just need to customize the OpenHAB 2 from the sitemaps to the rules for automation, which is what the next videos are going to be about. So please help me get these 5 videos in the automation server series to 200 likes, because I spend a lot of time on them and it motivates me to release the next videos faster. All right, thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below or head over to the mksmarthouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of getting answered. Goodbye.